Hey everybody, it's Bruce here with Traveling with Bruce. Welcome to my channel today. Thank you for subscribing to Traveling with Bruce, giving my videos thumbs up. So we now have 60,700 subscribers and it just keeps climbing. Love your comments too. Today's video might be a bit controversial. It's all about the commissions that travelers pay to go on a vacation. And in particular, I want to talk to you about the commissions that are out there to be earned once all of you take your cruise. Those of you who've been watching my channel, you know that we have not had a cruise booked for people really since March of 2020, approximately. We're now into the late part of October. We know that cruise lines hope to start in December, but only with a few ships. We're also aware that with this virus going around, we actually might not see cruising restart until February of next year. And so that could mark a full year where folks like this have not been able to take a cruise. Now, the stats out there vary, but we find that normally, when a cruise gets canceled, about 50% or so take their money back, and 50% of the passengers take a future cruise credit. Cruise lines have been throwing in all kinds of incentives to keep you from getting your money and sticking around a little longer. Travel agents around the world get paid commissions to book people on cruises or to places like this, all-inclusive resorts, where you just fly in with your ticket, stay here for a week or 10 days or 2 weeks, whatever it is, enjoy the amenities and fly home. It's a package deal, and travel agencies get paid commissions for the entire package. Your travel agent can be a local person that you know. Maybe you're shopping at a local shopping mall one day and you walk past a travel agency, or in your hometown you know of a travel agency right on Main Street in the heart of the town, or your friend of yours is into this, or you've discovered an online travel agent that you contacted, and you may have never met the person in the individual in person, but you're booking with them anyway. Depending on where in the world you are, travel agencies differ. Over the past years, Thomas Cook used to be a very big name in the travel game. They've had troubles, and some of these firms have reorganized. Others have gone belly up, but bottom line is there are storefronts, brick and mortar, and online, and stay at home travel agencies. But there are also large travel agencies out there that are staffed by hundreds of employees that are under a commission structure, a bonus structure, and they've been decimated over the past year. But now there is a thing brewing that is beginning to show, and it has begun actually to show in Australia, that apparently you, the cruise passenger, are a very, very valuable commodity, especially if you have a future cruise credit in your possession. If you have that, you are a target of potential poaching by some of these online entities. And I'll tell you all about this in just a minute. I just want to say again, thank you everybody for joining me. This video is being sponsored by you, all of you out there who watch me sponsor my channel, and I love you for it. Those of you watching ads on YouTube, subscribing to my channel, giving my videos thumbs ups, thank you very much. Especially those who are sponsor members of this channel, you absolutely support me directly. Join today and join me for two live sponsor shows just for sponsor members, one on Monday night at 7 Eastern and one on Fridays, 3 o'clock Eastern time, where we play trivia. And as a gift to you as a sponsor member, here is my latest postcard, custom made, autographed, and mailed to you around the world from Creston, British Columbia, just for being a sponsor member. And also those of you who are buying items on my Redbubble store, the link down below, you're also helping keeping me on the air, and I thank you very much. Now, in Australia, let me tell you the deal here. And I want to kind of give you some ideas of how big this really is. There are brick and mortar travel agents who are beginning to lose their clients. Clients that booked and paid for a cruise a year ago, 2 years ago, who had their cruises canceled and they ended up taking a future cruise credit. They're now being poached by online style travel agencies that are offering anywhere from a couple hundred dollars up to a $340-odd gift or credit against hotel stays, car hire, excursion credits, just to transfer your existing future cruise credit to their agency. And what happens is if you end up taking a cruise 3 months from now, 6 months from now, a year from now, the travel agent of record at that time will get the commission for your trip. Now, how much money am I talking about here? It all depends, of course, on the kind of cruise you're taking. But for example, it's not uncommon for, you know, folks out there to have a nice balcony cabin reserved on a ship, and each person might be paying $2,000 for a trip that they took with they booked with their agent. It might include the room and a few excursions. Maybe it include a drink package, a spa package. Everything was pre-included, pre-booked, and paid for, and now there's a big fat credit of $4,000 for a couple that is waiting to be utilized. The cruise lines may have thrown in a 10 to 30% bonus just to keep the credit, and so that the $4,000 amount that the customer paid for this vacation, it's actually worth $5,200 in future credit. But the bottom line is that the travel agency who scores the commission for that $4,000 purchase could be in line for about $640. And it's nothing to offer you an offer of, say, a $300 package, gift package, credit package, for you to switch over, because the travel agency is going to offer you, let's say, a free room in a hotel the night before your cruise. Well, if I'm going to order 100 rooms from the Ramada Inn hotel chain, I'm going to get a deal because I'm a travel agency and I'm going to get a block booking rate. It might cost me $50 where it might cost you $150. So I'm offering you a $150 gift for that room that's costing me actually $50. I throw in an excursion that might run me $40 that you would pay $120 for. And there you go. You're happy, and I'm delighted because I'm getting $640 for your vacation, and it cost me maybe $100 to get it. Who's unhappy? The original booking agent that did all the work to get you looked after. And that agent you might know personally, or you might not know personally. And this is where being an online travel agent is a little dicey, because if you don't know your clients on a personal level, you could be poached by larger, more aggressive entities. And what I'm talking about with money, folks, is this. 30 million people were supposed to take a cruise in 2020. About 22.5 million will not have taken a cruise in 2020. And then add the first 3 months of the new year, and we're up to 30 million people who won't have taken a cruise. Half will have taken their money back. Half will not. That's 15 million passengers out there with future cruise credits. I was doing some mathematics. At $2,000 a person with only 10 million cruisers with future cruise credits, that equals $20 billion in bookings that have not been used yet. The cruise lines are sitting on $20 billion cash, and commissions as high as 16% are paid out. That's $3.2 billion in commissions floating around out there to be earned by the travel agent that is the agent of record. So you are part of a pool of people, if you have a future cruise credit worth $3.2 billion and probably climbing at the rate of $300 million for every additional month of delays before we get back into cruising. So if this goes another 6 months, there's another $1.8 billion in commissions. Now it's up to $5 billion. You don't think travel agencies are going to battle for this money? Especially those large online agencies who've got power to really sweeten the pot to get you to switch. It's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. I feel sorry for the smaller brick and mortar agents, but I would say to them, be on top of your clients at all times. Be proactive. Always be talking to them. Don't wait for them to call you. You call them and keep them posted. You'll never lose them as a client. But there are some out there who are lazy and or don't realize their commissions might be poached by a larger fish. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's an interesting aspect of the cruise and travel business. We'll stay on top of these. Thanks again for joining me today here with Traveling with Bruce from Creston, British Columbia, Canada. Please consider becoming a sponsor member. Join me Monday nights at 7 o'clock, Friday at 3 o'clock in the afternoon Eastern Time for two sponsor member shows, and we even throw in some trivia. Thanks, everybody. Take care. Bye for now.